والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
جزاك الله خير شك. Okay, we had one of our younger callers, Brother Abu Bakr from Egypt, asking a very important question to him, which was aliens, Sheikh. Do they exist? Aliens?
There is a verse in the Quran which says, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And he creates what you guys do not know. Don't you think that we are the only creation in this universe? People who are scientific researchers, when you happen to look under the microscopic, the electronic microscope, just in your lab, the electronic microscope, you see another world, the viral world, the microbial world. You think that these guys and the microbes and the gram positive and the gram negative and the virus have their own life, which they do. You live with that as you are a part of it as long as you're looking at it. You think this is amazing, and it is indeed. As a matter of fact, in one of the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, you should run away from one who's leper, similar to running away from al-asad or the lion. And in pathology, they call the virus which causes the disease lion face. So if you happen to examine the virus under the electronic microscope, guess what? You see a lion face. You see a lion face. And that's why they call it in pathology a lion face. Mm-hmm. It's so amazing. So if this is the case with the small thing that we have in our hands and we deal with it on a daily basis, what about the different galaxies, the different planets? What about the different worlds? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The word Al-Alameen does not only mean the world of jinn and humans, ins and jinn, and that's it. No, no, no. Al-Alameen is everything that exists, whether we know it or we do not know it. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحَهُمْ. And there is nothing but glorifies the praise of Allah, whether we know it or not. But you do not understand how to. So there is a world of angels, jinn, humans, animals, plants, and aliens. Allah knows best about their being. Yet, we only know a little bit. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you know just a little bit of what He allows you to know. So if we happen to see scientifically a proof that there is some creation here, fine. This is not strange for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's able to do all things.
Jazakallah khair.
Before I answer this question, I just wanted to bring to the attention of all the viewers, not just the junior viewers, and especially the one who asked the previous question about aliens. When I answer that, of course, we're not talking about aliens which you watch on Hollywood, or they keep bringing up every day a new fictitious movie, and they say, we haven't seen them, so we don't know. And that's why, if you notice that, if there is any scientific fiction, or a movie, or a novel, the picture or the image of that alien is pretty close to human. Why? Because you cannot get something unless if you have visualize it physically. So that's why whatever they do, they come up by the end with something that is similar to human, that have four limbs, that speaks, that have eyes, maybe a huge nose, maybe horns, maybe huge ears. But by the end of the day, they make up something which we don't know if it does exist in the same form or image or not. About other creations, we only describe what we were able to see and visualize physically. So I don't want your mind to go there to what you watch in these movies.